Okay, team, what is going on? Happy Tuesday to everybody. And I hope you guys had a fantastic Memorial Day yesterday, that you had a chance to enjoy yourself a bit, spend some time with friends and family, and also take some time to reflect on why that day is a national holiday in this country and think about all the men and women who have sacrificed to allow us the freedoms and the opportunities that we have today. So if we didn't get a chance to think on those things, let's take some time today. Maybe some time this week, because I think that's important. And yes, we're supposed to enjoy ourselves over that long weekend, but it is also happening for a reason. And I think we have to remember that stuff, especially around this holiday. So just wanted to mention that before we hop into the episode and the context of our conversation for today, which is going to be habits and how habits kind of shape who we are, how they kind of shape our lives. And when I throw out this stat, I've mentioned this stat before, but I think it's something that's really important to remind ourselves of over and over and over again because of the significance of it. And that stat is this: when we think about our habits, our everyday habits, our day-to-day lives, things that we are kind of taking part in every single day, 40% of our days are consisted of habits. 40%. So let's say we live till we're 100 years old. 40 years of our life is habits, things that we have control over, things that we can implement into our day-to-day routines that can either have a benefit for us, kind of a neutral effect, or a negative effect on our lives. 40% of our days are habits. So what are we doing to establish positive, beneficial habits into our day-to-day activities? Because if they're going to have that profound of effect, maybe if it was 1 or 2%, yeah, you could put your eggs in a lot of different baskets, or maybe even 3 or 4 or 5%, but no, 40% of our days are consisted of habits. So maybe it's our morning routines, our routines at lunch, maybe in the evening, how we work out, how we talk to our spouse, how we talk to ourselves, how we continue to learn each and every day in some capacity, all these different things, these routines that we have in our life are so profound and are so significant. So how can we be better in pursuing these things for the better and establishing these habits and routines in our lives for the better? Are we all perfect in this pursuit when it comes to being excellent 40% of the time with these habits? No, sir. Absolutely not. But I think the realization that 40% of our days are these habits, it's going to kick us in the butt a little bit more to establish better habits in our lives. And how do we go about doing that? I talked about this one before. It's called anchoring. I try to do this. It's not the end all be all, but I think it's a very powerful tactic that we can use to implement these new habits. So for example, if you want to anchor your habits to something that you already do every single day. So for example, maybe it's in the morning. You know that you always eat breakfast, so that you always have a cup of coffee in the morning. Fantastic. So if you want to implement a new morning routine or something along those lines, maybe it's praying more, meditating more, breathing a little bit more effectively, anchor those new habits that you want to establish in your life to some things that you know that you're already going to be doing. So you do have that cup of coffee in the morning. Fantastic. You're going to say, I want to meditate for 5 minutes every single day before I have that cup of coffee in the morning. Fantastic. Or maybe it's at dinner. You want to spend 5 minutes with your family before you have dinner talking about your days. You know you're going to eat dinner every single night with them. Fantastic. So anchor those new habits to that time at dinner time, right? So that's anchoring habits, a thing that you already do, which will allow you to create better habits when it comes to that 40%. Because think about if we can improve in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ways in our habits with that 40%, you multiply that over the course of our entire lives, we are talking big time stuff, y'all. We are talking really, really, really big time stuff. So when it comes to our habits this week, how can we establish better ones? How can we establish new ones? How can we ditch old ones to allow for more room for new ones to be created or to be developed? That's the perspective I encourage us to take on this week. I most certainly need to be better in that kind of realm right now. Maybe getting in a little rut because of the new normal with everything going on. We're all there. We're all experiencing it. Let's rally around each other. Let's rally around ourselves to make sure our habits are what they need to be so we can keep progressing ourselves in the right direction. Because lastly, 40% of our days, 40% are consisted of habits. How are we choosing to go about that 40%? Let's make it a great week, y'all. I love you guys. I appreciate you guys. If you have any questions, concerns, please holler at me. But big time stuff moving forward. And this week is going to be a great one. I can feel it as long as we are purposeful in making that happen. Let's do it, y'all. God bless you guys. Coach Cool.